Let me go to this one. You can see this one in your Zoom, right? Let me start the class as usual. We will talking about the syllabus, and you can download the syllabus from our Facebook group. And since you have the mechanics of material with me, so you guys are supposed to get used to with my style and uses. And usually you may email me anytime. Most of the time I respond with the email pretty quick, okay, compared to the other communication method. And there is this textbook that P. Bundam already provided you the link. And if you are Thai, you may study the Thai first and read the English. That's usually the best way for Thai people when they went to the US to study in English. And anyway, if you prefer, you may use the other way. And then for this one, always the objectives of learning. And you should think why the government, the university, the school like you to study this class. And then over the overall big picture, you study this one in order you to study the design classes. Why? Typically, the structure must be analyzed first, and then you get the result, the internal force, the internal moment. You use that for the design. And then in the design, it's different. You may design the steel structure, the reinforced concrete structure, or even the aluminum structure for some typical, very special building. That's one. Second, if you prefer to have the engineering license, not only in Thai, you may have the Asian engineering license. Okay, you got to study this class in order you to have a good practice and apply for the license. Okay, and for more thing else, let us put back to the main objective of the class that you're supposed to do first. Upon successful study this class, we expect you to understand the concept of theory and method for analyzing the two-dimensional problem. Okay, allow us, the structure seems to be three-dimensional, but luckily, our engineering sense and engineering judgment, we can simplify the three-dimensional structure into two dimension. Okay, not only the structure, the soil, the rock, okay, you also can simplify it into 2D in the computer program such as PAXIS. Bundam, usually they use only two dimensional first before you go deep into the three dimension, because it requires a lot of resources, computation resources for the three dimension. And then there are tasks, and I like you guys to link between what you are learning and what you see around us. Thinking about the task, you go out of the class, you look at the roof, okay? You can see the structure that's supporting the roof sheet to prevent from the wind, to prevent from the sunshine, those kind of things. And for the task, if you walk into the student activity buildings, you will see the green structure that's linked between two parts of the road. That's also the bridge task. Okay, let's go over there and enjoy how thinking about how you're going to analyze it, how you're going to design it, okay, even how you're going to construct it. That's going to be your future occupation as a good engineer. You got to link. That's important between your knowledge and the real thing. That's allow us, okay? The second one is the beam. There is a lot of beam, okay, in the building. You just thinking about how the load transfer from the floor to the beam. Have you ever think about it? ที่มันทำได้เก่ง in the touchstone design we know the force always transfer from the roof okay transfer to the truss and then the load from the floor transfer to the beam okay and then from the beam it's transfer to the column and then when you combine the beam with the column it's called the frame okay in the computer programThat you guys supposed to have it. Do you guys have the substructure yet? You download it yet? SVG structure, substructure. You got to download it from the Facebook. That is the link, okay? To download it and install in your computer program. That program was developed by your senior, okay? He is the first man.And in the master degree level, now he working at the Mahasarakham University, okay. And then there are some superior structure that is the arch. You may see the arch in many bridges and in many airplane hangar. It require superior structure because the airplane is so big. Okay, the wing of the airplane.And then since the arch have this kind of shape, so it's proper for the airplane hangar. That's for parking the airplane. And then there is the cable. Okay, if you go to Bungdalua, you will see a bridge. That's with use the cable. Okay, supporting the substructure. And then that's.All the structure require you guys to have what the concept, okay, and the theory under it. And the main thing, whatsoever is the task, is the beam, is the frame, is the arch, is the cable, under the application of the force, or of this structure, the material, or of this structure must be in the linear.Elastic behavior, and then the structure must be formed very small. It have very small deformation. I like to mention this one thing: the structure must be linear elastic because when it's subjected to the force, and then when the force relief, thinking about this room, okay, or somehow.The class is full of students, okay. The load going to apply to the fork, transfer to the beam, okay. Then the beam supposed to receive the load safely. And then after finish the class, everybody got out of the room. So the beam supposed to rebound back, right? And for the linear elastic, the structure will rebound back to its original position.And then during all the people staying over here, okay, the for the beam, the column must resist the load or forces with very small deformation. So we don't feel anything. And then all of this was set up for our civil engineering structure, all way like that.But if you go to the Facebook, I post the wing of the airplane, and you can see during the takeoff, the wing of the airplane vibrate like this. Okay, but that is the function of the wing of the airplane. Again, can I design the wing of the airplane very stiff? You can. The airplane wing will be a lot heavier, and then.Your airplane going to consume a lot of fuel, and then your airplane going to be more expensive compared to the competitor, and then you cannot sell the airplane. Okay, so a proper design depends on the field of engineering, but this group is for our field. Okay, now the second one, you got to recognize the limit and assumption.Used to develop the theory and method. Okay, that's going to lead to the link here, elastic, the small deformation, talking about the beam. And then if you recall back to the mechanics of material, we have the theory such as the elastic beam theory. That's used to what? That's used to develop the equation of the deflection of the beam. And then you have the deflection table, right? All that table, the equation table, come from this one. And this elastic beam theory based on this assumption and concept. Okay, and now for the third one, if you get the result, such as again, the beam, you have the beam with the span of, let's say, 3.6 meter. And then you compute based on elastic beam theory. And then you get the deflection of 1 meter. Is that possible in our engineering structure? That's really huge, right? 3.6 meter, but your beam defect for 1 meter. That's supposed to be wrong solution. Okay, it's not applicable to our structure. Is it possible something wrong in your calculation, or your beam is very, very small compared to the size magnitude of the world? Okay, and that called adding sense. A lot of the time when you get the result, you're supposed to be, hey, that may not be the answer. Okay, like I tell you, that is 3.6 meter beam. It's going to be 3,600 millimeter. Even though you compute the deflection to be like 200 millimeter, that's considered too large for our assumption. And that's called adding sense. And then you do the adjustment. That's going to be wrong. You got to do another check. Okay, that's going to call the edging adjustment. And those kind of edging sense and edging adjustment are important to your future career. And then this is our Facebook group, and I will ask you guys again to join us. And since only let me recall. And then why this one? I only tell you to going to practice as the engineer. You supposed to thinking about thing around you guys, okay, and try to model it from this real structure, and then you modify model into this one, and then you use what? You always use the free body diagram and equation of equilibrium. You still use it a lot, okay, until you graduate. And then under the application of the force, this one must be in equilibrium. And thinking about you hold this one, and then you put the force under it, and they're supposed to have something occur on the support. Support over here must have reaction in order to keep this structure in equilibrium. So, okay, up to this point, you're going to use the equation of equilibrium to determine the reaction. So just use what you have from the engine static. Summation of x sub x equal to zero. Prevent this one from move in the horizontal direction. And if you say, if this is positive, you're supposed to keep the direction. Okay, for this one, you will have a sub x equal to zero. And then if you want to prevent the movement of the beam in the vertical direction, and then you said if this one is positive, so a sub y gonna be positive. And then since this is the uniformly distributed load, from the weight of this one, okay, or the wood, okay, and then the resultant force is going to be 40 kilonewton. Why it come from? I just say If this is 10 kilonewton per meter, it's 1, 10, 20, 30, and 40. Okay, you got just 10 kilonewton per meter times 4 meter. It's going to be 40 kilonewton. And then that is what? That is downward. It's minus 40 equal to 0. If you prefer to calculate it systematically, it's going to be like this. So next, UA sub Y is only 40 kilonewton. That's going to be the force prevent the movement of this one in the vertical direction. And it depends. If this is the concrete, do just put this beam into the concrete. The concrete will resist the applied force. But if this one is the steel, okay, like people have know about it, if you put this one in the steel plate, you got to put the bolt, okay, and then you got to design it by the steel design. But if you put it in the concrete, you just design it based upon reinforced concrete design. It depends, okay, and then to prevent it from rotation, summation of the moment about point A equal to 0. And if you follow this one, counterclockwise as the positive. So your M sub A is positive. And then this is going to be the location of the centroid of the resultant. And this is rectangular. So this is going to be 2 meters. And then the moment going to be in opposite direction. You may say this is going to be negative 40 times 2 equal to 0. So your M sub A is going to be 80 kilonewton meter. So this is what engine static. Now, let Ajahn ask you again, is this in our study? Not yet. Following this moment that you get, and the A sub Y and A sub X that you get is going to be the reaction at the support. And then you may recall back to the engine static. What else do we need? What else? From this solution, what else? You got to draw the shear diagram and moment diagram. Okay, you know about these two diagrams. We draw them for what? To determine the maximum moment. You get the maximum moment for what? For what? To determine the section. Remember? And then after you get the section, let's say you get the section to be rectangular or to be the eye, whatsoever is up to you. Rectangular supposed to be the wood, okay? This one supposed to be the steel. And next, you got to check. This section is large enough to what? To resist the Vmax from the shear diagram. See, they are related to each other between the modeling, okay, between the analysis, and then what the design. Okay, then you have the size of the beam, you got to design the connection. Okay, and the last one you do what? You dock it, okay, and then you estimate the cost, and then you have the construction, okay, based on the cost that you estimated. So that's all engineers supposed to do, modeling. Most of the time it comes from the planning, analyzing, designing, and construction. And then what you do is going to require your engineering sense, okay? What's going to be engineering sense? If this one is reinforced concrete, if I ask Pi Bun Tham about how we should reinforce this beam, Pi Bun Tham will answer me directly. But how about you? Can you do that? Not yet, but you will later. After you study about this course, and then you know that this one is going to subjected to the tier diagram like this, and this one will subjected to the moment diagram like this, and the moment is negative. Okay, based upon the knowledge of in static, Pibundam will tell you exactly if you decide this one for the reinforced concrete, you guys to must reinforce this beam by this reinforcement on the top. Why? If this one is the reinforced concrete, why you got to put the steel on the top? Why don't you put the steel on the bottom? Go back to mechanics of material, and you will learn again in the marine testing. Concrete is good for compression, but concrete is not good for tension. And then we got to put the steel to resist the tension. And then you got to hook the steel also to have a good bond, a good bonding between the concrete and steel, right? That's all called the incense. Okay, you got to have it. For this one also, you got to cook it. Now, move it a bit to this one. And then, if it's the reinforced concrete, it's going to be rectangular section. That's score our consideration into the reinforced concrete. You won't notice most of the reinforced concrete in this position. The reinforced concrete usually look like this, the section. Okay, look at this. Why you see most of the structure have the this kind of beam more than this kind of beam? Can you answer to me? Pibundam, can you tell them? Yeah. Thank you, Pibundam. Did you hear Pibundam teach you? Why? Okay, this one has higher moment of inertia about this axis, right? So, based upon the axis that's passing to the centroid of the section, I, for this one, gonna be 3 times 10 cubed divided by 12. Okay, but for the C, you got what? The moment of inertia about this axis, I, is going to be 10 times T cubed over 12. Okay, you can see the beam at B is having the larger moment of inertia. So when you go back to the stress, sigma equal to my over I. See, when the I is large, the stress is small. Okay, for B, you also have V max. Okay, let's say if you have the simple beam subjected to distributed life load, that is going to be the variable and constant and divided by I. So larger I, smaller deflection. Larger I, smaller stress. Okay, and then that is other thing. Study this one to have the foundation to study more advanced courses. That's objective of our learning. And the last one, you got to have the earning license. And Pibundam, you also can apply for it. But for special license, I don't know you love to have it or not. But just focus to your work, okay? Not everything, but you can have many, many specialty, so you can work over here. And then after practice, for some, คุณดัม you can apply for Asian engineer license and then you can come back and work for the whole thing it's going to be like this okay it's not the direct way but for the foreigner if you prefer to work over here in Thailand okay you can do like that take special engineering license work okay until you have enough experience you use that experience apply for Asian engineer and then you can work in every country in this Asian region okay and then this is require you and then you can see healing of structure is over here and you also require this one okay structural analysis there is two part first part is on the top that's for the general engineering courses you got to have more than 60% to pass it for four subjects and then for your special process also it require you to take this is first step this is second step this is third step and then this is your choice okay all of them going to be 100% you got to have again larger than or equal to 60% to pass okay you understand right any question on this yes
I think the just
yes, you may work and you have your senior to approve it. But that one may require a year or 2 years. If your senior is a bad guy, it may require you more than that. Okay. And if you have enough knowledge, just take it. You got the license immediately. And if you like to be the owner of a company in some situation, you don't like to work for the people, that is another situation. But that's a good way. It's a good comment on this. If you prefer, you also don't need to take the license, but you got to work for some people and they, until they are very satisfied with you, they can approve you. And in the past, in my generation, it would have the examination, but it requires your teacher to approve you. That is another way. But you got to get the grade of all the courses, okay? At least C. For example, if you have a theory of structure deduct, you cannot. You got C. You have to replicate it to get C. And then just the signature of your teacher. That's it. It's kind of go back to the old day. Just change from the teacher to anybody. But in the old day, you got to cut at least C every courses. But for this day, I don't know. It's going to be good or bad. But that is the good old day. Okay. Now, what the content we are supposed to have? We are going to talk about various types of structure. And I did mention some for you guys already. This is going to be the task. Okay. This is going to be the cable. Go to Bung Talua. You get this one. And this portion is going to be the beam. When you consider the beam connect rigidly with the column. You got the frame, okay? That is the end of this chapter. Now, we have the load, okay? There are two types of load. One, the load that's always there. We call this one the dead load. Dead load most of the time is the cell weight of the structure, such as the cell weight of the floor, cell weight of the beam, cell weight of the column. That is the dead load. But another thing is the load that moves depends on the function of the building. This is university building, okay? Then the magnitude of the life load must be at least 300 kilograms per square meter, at least. You may use 500, you may use 600, depends on you, okay, according to the law. But if this one is a kindergarten classroom, you may reduce this one to like 150, okay? Depend on the function because the kid is smaller than the big guy. But In my recommendation, I don't recommend you to use 150. Why? Because the loan may be used at the parent meeting. See, big people also come to the kindergarten. So again, I recommend you to use 300 kilograms per square meter. If talking about it, Thibun Tham will answer the same as me, for sure. Okay? It depends on our engineering judgment. See? It's the judgment. It's not wrong to use 150. Okay? But you may use your judgment to increase the life load to decide the building to be 300. And also, the way to do so, you also explain to the owner also, because the cost of your building will be more expensive, depending on the magnitude of the load, larger load. Okay, you will get larger shear force, larger moment, thicker force, larger beam, larger column, but the structure will very durable. So it's up to the decision. Okay, and then I should say everything civil engineer do based upon the law. The law also require is a minimum requirement by the law. You cannot set it by yourself. You can set it larger magnitude compared to the law, but you cannot use smaller. Okay, that is going to be your work. And then this is second thing. So structure is very easy. Okay, very easy software. You are Pella Wiki. Okay, over there you see the pin, the pin roller, you will see a fixed support, you will see the beam member, you will see the truss member, you will draw your picture of the structure. What you see is what you get. Unlike me, 30 years ago, I used the program called Microfit. It's very original version of most of the computer analysis program developed at Berkeley, using of Clifford at Berkeley. A professor, Wanasak Kanoknukunchai, he take the program from the US and develop more here, over here at AIT. And at the time, it's not like this. Every member have the connection. You did everything close to the survey. You got to put the coordinate, okay? Coordinate A, coordinate B, coordinate C, coordinate D. And then you got to say, okay, the first member, you connect coordinate A with the coordinate B. And then you got to say, coordinate member two, coordinate B with coordinate C. Nowadays, you just that the line, you get the member, okay? So your life is going to be easy. But if you have the problem using this one, I think Thibun Tham, he is very potential people, the resource person, you may ask him. But I don't think Thibun Tham asks anybody when you practicing this one, I also. And then there is a manual, but written in Thai by Ajahn Sat many years ago. And then we will study the task. And then we will study the beam and the frame. And then we will have the first midterm examination. Okay? The old stuff. But for sure, the examination should not be the same as that we have for the in-static, right? We have 15 in the in-static, right? Has been framed. But this one is a bit more complicated problem. Don't worry. To enhance yourself. And then we go to chapter 4 and chapter 5 for the cable and arch and then the inference line. Then we get the second midterm examination. Okay, that is going to be in the university schedule. Then we study the defection with various methods. There are double integration methods that you have it already. Conjugate beam, virtual work, those kind of thing, and then virtual work for task, for beam, for frame, and then what you have is the third midterm examination. Most of the time it's in the week of 10 or 11. Okay. And then all of this, the structure going to consider as the statically determinate structure. What is mean? All of this structure can be analyzed based upon free body diagram and equation of equilibrium. Okay, good old stuff is going to be easy structure. Okay, for the beam, you may see this kind of statically determinate beam go to Samyakta. Okay, that is the bridge there. The all of the precast, pre-stress beam for those kind of bridges, they are statically determinate. Okay, for the task, the green task near the activities building is also statically determinate. Okay, you will see some structure are statically determinate, but most of the structure, okay, they are statically indeterminate. Okay, in the mechanics of material, you have it already. Remember, for the axial load, remember the problem number three in the midterm examination. Okay, that's one you use what's so called the compatibility condition. And then when you use condition, when you use this condition combined with free body diagram and equation of equilibrium, you can solve, okay, those kind of statically indeterminate for extra unknown. Okay, you have unknown, number of unknown larger than the number of equations of equilibrium, right? So you write this one to add more equation, and then you solve all the equation, you get the result. And then this one not that simple. Axial load member, you're going to involve with the beam, the frame, and the truss. And this is the example for the frame. This frame can be considered as the statically indeterminate, since the support on this frame is fixed. Okay, so there is six unknown going to be six. You have only three equations. This frame in our F4 building, you go to the F4 building, you take a look at it. Okay, you cannot solve it easily by manual calculation, but you can solve it very easy by using substructor, and I design this frame by using substructor. That is 20 plus years ago. Okay, and a number of graduate students get it by this frame. One, two PhD, and no, actually, some PhD of Ajahn Suksan also use this frame. Okay, and a number of master degree, like 12 of me, and maybe like 30 for Ajahn Suksan get it from this one. They call this one like Ajahn also. And also, this is the precast beam. And on this configuration, this is the testing system to verify the design of this precast structure. Okay, so this one is statically determinate. So in this picture, you have the beam, statically determinate. You have the frame, statically indeterminate. Okay. And then you got the final examination that is going to be in the university schedule. And this is the substructor program. You may download it over there. Okay, you have the link. And the conduct of course, I don't know, let me hope it to be like 10%. it's maybe the homework like the previous courses, and it's also maybe the class attendance. And then I mentioned about there are a lot of midterm examination, three of them. And then the score supposed to be like this one, okay? And don't worry, A still 80. Anybody who gets above 80, they always A. But for the F, it's supposed to be like a 48, 47. Last time, mechanics of material is really low, like 45, okay? It's not a lot of people will get the F. We got to help students sometimes. And this is a paper Ajahn Phorn Phot developed it. Actually, he used the Chulalongkorn University pattern, but Chulalongkorn University pattern also used the this kind of paper from the US pattern. So this one we use in this task. It's also be used in the material testing laboratory. What I'm tell you, you got to copy the lab manual, right? So print it and start do the copy. And that's going to help you later. And then you got to attend the class. And we have seen it. Two of them won't come over here. And actually, no person with me like two times already. But anyway, they got to help themselves. And that is the policy, okay, the same as we have in the mechanics of material. And this is an important Facebook, even though most of the content is in Thai, you may use the Google to translate it. Okay, one is so-called the Engineering Institute of Thailand. And although you have the Engineering Institute of Cambodia or not, but somehow in the, if not, somehow in the future, Buddham may join with some senior engineer and establish this kind of engineering institute in the future. And this one is for professional, okay, most of the time. But this one is legal. This is the Council of Engineer Thailand. There are different institutes, okay? And please join their Facebook to update yourself. And there is a lot of knowledge in the website of the Engineering Institute of Thailand, because a lot of Ajahn work for free for this one, okay? And we usually post some new knowledge on this Facebook and website. This is the RICO Institute. This one provides the engineering license for civil engineer, electrical engineer, industrial engineer, those kind of engineering. And that's all for the introduction. Let me take a 5 minute break. Okay. let me start for our chapter one. And I did tell you a bit about type of the structure and also type of the load. Okay, level kit. That is dead load and live load for the load. Okay, and you got to think, recall it from the first part of this lecture. You got to know dead load is what, live load is what, okay? And then what the type of structure you can recall it, and you got to understand what going to be task, okay? What's going to be beam, frame, arch, and cable. There is many of them. And then the type of load, as I mentioned, and I should say, this is going to relate for the legal stuff. It's a requirement, okay, to specify the load on the structure. And structure is what? Structure can be anything combined together, okay? It can be beam joined with the column, joined with the task, okay? You can go over there, take a look on the roof, okay, to see all that combination. And with this combination, the duty of that is going to be received It's going to resist all the required applied forces and loads, okay, to perform its intent function. This Suratnapa tower have the function as the symbol of this university. And on top of this one, actually, there is a fort used to observe, okay, the whole university. Such as fire occur on this weekend, okay, they use this one to observe how large the fire is spreading. And then they have planned to prevent the fire spreading. And this is used to be the tallest building in Thailand, Bayok Tower 2. Before Bayok Tower 2, there is Bayok Tower 1. Okay, this is about 40 plus years old. This is about 25 plus years old nowadays. The tallest building is about 2 times taller than this. But for any kind of such as wind load, okay, not only life load plus death load, this structure will subjected to a large storm, okay, huge thunderstorm, okay, and then large wind forces applied into it. Not only this one also earthquake, okay, earthquake load, that also may occur. There are small earthquake load, okay, transfer the force from the northern part of Thailand and Myanmar into Bangkok. That is the shaking of this kind of tall building, but there is no damage to them because they are designed to receive large wind load and earthquake load. That's basis on what? Engineering sense and adjustment. Go back over there. How can you estimate the wind load, Bundam? Right? You got to go back like 100 years record of wind speed that occur in Thailand. And if you like to be more safer, there may be the record for 200 years. It's up to you which one is the best way to do so. But most of professional, they also do the analysis of this thing already, and they write up the design code, okay, to prevent the wind, to prevent the earthquake already. So just follow it, okay, and that is going to be a specific thing if you like to be a good structural engineer, work for the high-rise building, okay, and then that is the other structure that's similar to our Suratnapa tower, okay? And then there is various civilization occur for civil engineer, not only in Thailand, it's also in your country. I didn't have a chance to visit Nakhon Wat Nakhon Thom yet, but I will in the future for sure. This is from Egyptian, the old Egyptian that is 400 years ago, how can they build it? Okay, that is going to be very, very great work of them. And nowadays, you may see one of the biggest experimental on this earth, okay, at the CERN. And like 5 years ago, they start to study and found the Higgs. Okay, and that is the phenomena, the origin of our universe. And this kind of thing have a very large kernel under the ground. Okay, it's very perfect circular. So the light can have allow it and accelerate into the speed near the speed of the light. That is very, very marvelous of this kind of thing. I went there. And me going to be very small. The tunnel is very huge. And then how you guys going to do it? For sure, we going to develop ourselves depend on our experience. And then you got to choose the field. Like Bundam, he is now in geotechnical engineering, and it's also field such as water resources engineering. structural engineering, surveying, those kind of things. Okay, and nowadays there is a lot of modern technology into our field. You got to start from to starter, to sketch up, AutoCAD, develop yourself into a more advanced program. In the soil, you may use the PACSIS. In the structural engineering, you may use like a step 4, ETAP, SAP 2000, those kind of thing. And also there is the finite element software, okay, such as NASTAN, Abacus, those kind of thing. And in the surveying, drone technology is coming. Last year, I don't remember Phi Bun Dam joined us or not, about this time in April, there is a company spend only 2 days to scan our university for 6,000 plus lines, okay, within 2 days. And then they also do the 3D model, the data generate, and then use the graphical program to do so. So you got to get used to with this kind of graphic, okay, for especially for the main step of the planning. You got to plan the structure basis of all your professional, okay, and then you got to plan it for not only aesthetic, also safety and economy. You may build the same structure, but the structure can cost the owner 1,000 million baht. Can be 1,200 million baht or only 800 million baht. But the structure at 800 million baht should not as tall as the structure with 1,000 million baht. Okay, but it's up to your judgment, it's up to the budget of the owner of the building. And also you got to put the material which one you're going to use in this portion of the structure. You can see the parts on the roof made by the steel, okay, and then you can see most of the beam is the reinforced concrete. You got to decide it. That's why you got to study the cost of material testing, because the material must follow Thailand industrial standard. That is, again, is the legal setup. You got to follow it for buying a specific material. We will talk again, okay, tomorrow. And then for a forehand, for a dimension, that's going to basis upon what so called the objective, okay, of the building and objective of the area. And then you will use your knowledge, what so called combined with the building code, okay. And if you like to have a Thai building code, you can download it. But I didn't see it in English, Bundam. Most of them just in Thai. And that is going to be the legal document. The load must be taking from, again, from this one. You can use larger value, but you cannot use smaller value. And then based upon analysis, you got to think which kind of material you use, because all of the material have different behavior, have different what so called the design procedure. And then you may need to use the design code in combination with the building code, okay? And then you start to do what supposed to be is called the model of the structure. You got to decide kind of support. Why? Because if Bun Tham said this is the pin, when Phi Bun Tham decide it, Phi Bun Tham must decide it as the pin. Okay, he cannot decide it at the roller because it's not follow the analysis. Okay, and if you say this is a roller, how you going to build it? And from the capstone design, I always said Hey, if it's possible, I don't recommend you to use thin roller because roller in construction is going to be very tough to build. Just use pin, okay? And then the detail between this side going to be the same. It's going to be easy to construct, Bunnam, okay? Because it's the same, right? So the support going to be easy to build. You don't need to separate them. And then you got to design the configuration. There is various type of tasks, fling task, hover task, those kind of tasks. Okay, which one you prefer? Okay, that's you're going to be the starting point. And then for this idealization, if you do it correct, okay, your analysis will be correct. And then your calculation will provide you from the expected load to the internal forces and moment, also for the deformation of the structure. And most of the time, again, in your profession, most of the time you will use computer program, okay? And you got to start with manual calculation first in order to make you get used to it, the computer program later. And the best way is you got to just verify between the computer result and your manual calculation. And that is going to be in the capstone design to make your guy confident in yourself before you go out to work. And then there is a lot of collapse of the structure. This one occurred in 2013 in Ayutthaya area. It's a bridge, okay? It's a cable bridge. Just collapse. That is due to a problem in the construction, not in the design. But you may see using too small cable size. If not due to the construction, it may be due to the design. It may be due to the analysis. On our occupation, the first bottom must be correct, and the follow bottom will be correct later. Okay, so start with a good idealization or modeling of the structure. Follow the law in your country. Follow the acceptable design code. You like to do so, and then you design it. In my opinion, the design is not that hard if you do a good modeling, and a good modeling is based upon the knowledge how to build it. If you don't know about this one or of the capstone design, I always ask first how you going to build it before you do the modeling. And then if that one is correct, the design is just follow the step. Why I say that? You can program the design procedure in Excel. Anything that can put in the Excel is going to be systematics, right? Do you have structural analysis program in the Excel format? I don't think so. Okay, you got to write it in the program, but the design, you can put it in the Excel. And then you're going to use a lot of computer program nowadays, depend on you. And one of very popular nowadays is the Revit. But it depends on you, what you are going to do. If you are going to work in like a company that will build very big structure and complex structure, such as big house, you don't need a lift, right? But if you guys work in a structure such as the Bohr-Newton capture therapy building that has the reactor inside it, it has a very complicated system of the building, a lot of wire, a lot of tube, a lot of pipe in that building. Very sure, you got to have the living since the start of the project for the original concept, modeling, analysis, design, do the construction and put it in the database. And then that's for the maintenance because the reactor, if it has something mistake, it will cause very big problem, right? But if you build a house, a tallest building, those kind of thing, I don't think so. Okay, but knowing it is good. Like my daughter in Silvakorn University, they also use another computer program. It's called Hino, H-I-N-O. Okay, I depend on you. Okay, and then different company also use different computer program, but start with the good concept of computer application. That's going to be good for you. And then you do the construction. After finish, you design, you will have the hand of your structure. But this one is the reinforcement of the beam. You put it into the real thing. Cool. That's state of the art. You require a lot of skill, okay, to put the steel like that. But you got to follow the law, okay, by investigation of the construction, and you got to follow the contract, you got to follow the specification of the material. All of this is the legal. So engineer should have knowledge about related law, okay. And in my generation, we study one course called contract law and specification. But nowadays, I don't know how come university don't have this one, but I think it's important. Okay, the same way that you drive vehicle, you got to know the law, traffic law, those kind of things. And then there is various type of structure. One important thing is the pilot. If you go to the F5 building, there is the lot in the X shape like this on the roof of your structure. That prevents what? Lateral force, especially the wind. Okay, and it's important if you don't put it when the structure subjected to the storm. Okay, your whole structure can collapse easily without it. And it's going to be very small design, right? Yeah, and very simple. And this is the example of the beam. You know about the beam, right? The beam, most of the time, support the floor. The weight of the floor transfer to the beam. And the beam depend on your design. Okay, if you design it, such as this beam, okay, you got to model it according to what you should be. Since this beam is not aligned with the top beam, you may just consider this is just a one span beam. And then for the connection, it depends on you. You can set it to be fixed support. And if it's fixed support, you got to provide the detail over here, at the fixed support. Okay, if not, it's going to be pin support, and you got to design it at the pin. It depends on you. And then when this kind of beam have the unknown equal to number of equations, such as this one, 2, 1, that is going to be pin and roller. Unknown here is 2, this one is 1, total is 3. You have 3 equations, okay? But for the structure, that has a lot of support over here, this one seems to be the roller. Since the number of reactions larger than the number of equations, this is statically indeterminate. And then there is I section beam. When I section beam, the flank, top, and bottom used to resist the moment. And then we use the web to resist the shear. Remember, we check the shear stress in our class, how max equal to, for this one, V max divided by A web, approximately like that. And then there is the reinforced concrete. And again, you will reinforce the main bar to resist the tension for the positive moment. Like this one, you reinforce at the bottom. Okay, and then this is in negative moment, you reinforce it at the top. Okay, it's different. And then we use the stirrup. This one is the stirrup to resist the shear force. The same thing as the web. The stirrup is in the vertical direction. And then we come to the real thing over here that I mentioned about the main reinforcement and then the stirrup over here. And the way to dock it nowadays, that is both in two dimension and three dimension, and you can generate this kind of detail by using BIM program. Okay, and then the construction going to be easier to do so. And four of our students work with Supalai last term. The problem of Supalai is this: they expand the business to Dhani, and then they cannot find good subcontractor, and they have the problem. The subcontractor build the house, such as stair. The reinforcement of the stair is really complicated. Okay, our student use the second app to draw the three dimensions, the steel reinforcement for the stair. And then that's very simple. No, I don't think, because you got to make sure every step that is 10 times of house. So there is going to be 10 times of step. Okay, you got to make sure every step have a three-dimensional modeling, a good one. Okay, in order the contractor can take a look at it and then go and build it. And I ask you guys again, if you have time, you may study all this thing based on yourself. There is on YouTube actually for a good start, and for a more complex problem, you may need to pay the money for it. And then the column subjected to the compression when the load from the floor transfer to the beam to the column. And then the column also may be subjected to the bending moment if the column connected to the beam in the frame. That column will subjected to moment also. We call it beam column. And that is a strategic design. For the column only, the design is going to be very easy. But for the beam column, the equation is going to be a bit more complicated. Okay, you will learn it from Ajahn Mong Phun or Ajahn Nok later. And then for the task, we have, again, loop task and with task recall from the editing static, the joint of the task is going to be pin, okay? And then the load apply at what? At the joints. And then you can see the load going to apply and transfer to the joints of the task. And also from this one, you got to put the purlin. So the weight from the loop sheet transfer to the purlin, and the reaction from the purlin will act on the loop. The problem of the task is not only the vertical force due to the gravity, the loop also subjected to the wind load, and the wind load can be in many directions. It can be in this direction, it can be in this direction, and then it's subjected to compression, and it's also subjected to the tension. That's simple structure, right? But since the roof is on the top of the building, and it's going to subjected to various types of loading. Actually, it has temperature change also. Okay, so please open your mind and trying to think about how the structure gonna subjected to various types of loading, and then you will comprehend what happened. And then the task is good for the structure with the long span. Okay, and then you can see the task used in the bridge and also the task used in the loop. And why it is good? Because due to the connecting member, okay, the task can have large depth. So the top for the vertical loop, the top will be in compression, the bottom will be in the tension. And then by configuration of the task, the use of the material in the task is very high efficiency. And then Later, we have this one. You may go outside over there on in the front of 300 seat building. You have this type of task for the loop task. You know this one, right? Before you come over here, you drive your motorcycle passing to this task. And there is another structure called the cable. Okay, most of the cable is intention, and this cable act very similar to the cable that's used to transmit the electricity. Some transfer from the Laos to over here by using the cable. And then the cable can use the structure very long span. And one of very renowned cable, what's so called suspension bridge, is the Golden Gate Bridge in the US. And you can see these various type of suspension bridge in Thailand. You may go to Bung Ta Lua. Okay, that is going to be the closest cable suspension bridge in our area. And this one is the picture of it. And you can see the span from here to here is very large across the this one to this one. I think it's nearly like 30 meters. And then you can walk, you can jog, okay, passing through it. And also there is another type. This one is not the cable in our study. This one is called cable stay bridge, not suspension bridge. This is special type of bridge, okay? Is used in very large, very huge bridge, more advanced than what we have. And then there is the arch. This is the support center, okay? And then that is very huge arch. So you can see the stand on the left and on the right. So you have the stand for in the middle for like a playing badminton, basketball, those kind of things. And most of the time, the arch receives the force by developing the compression force inside it. And also, there is another frame. You see this one before, right? Again, on the activities building, you see the frame. The frame is the combination of the portion. This is similar to the beam and connected to the column and connect by the rigid joint. This one called cable frame, okay? It's cable because it has this kind of roof and it's very popular in Thailand. A lot of house based on that. And also the frame can be in a bridge. Okay, this one is going to be the frame that's supporting the superstructure of the bridge, and is going to be statically indefinite, most of the frame. You got to use the computer program to do the analysis. But for this subject, we're going to consider only statically determinate on the first portion. Until the final, we will have the statically indeterminate frame. And there is various frame. There are statically determinate frame. This is a gas station. And also you have this one in the harbor area used to transport the commodity to a large, like this one, to a large ship. And most of them are, for the frame, statically indeterminate, very simple reinforced concrete house, okay, or a more complicated steel building. And there is steel frame, walking area, again, so this activity one, okay, this is called what? Called the frame to be this one. This is the column and this is the beam. You have this kind of rigid connection, and then you have this kind of rigid foundation. This pattern is going to be the simplest rigid frame. Okay, for our study, and you supposed to use any static to analyze for the reaction. You got to be able to determine the reaction. You got to the shear diagram. You got to the moment diagram. You got to not yet the deflection. You will find the deflection later when you finish this class. Okay, and again, you have you should be able to analyze this one. This is a purlin. You can model it as a simple bean. Okay, and then you can again find the reaction, find the shear diagram, moment diagram, and then you start upon the knowledge that you have now. Upon the knowledge that you have now, on the second year, you supposed to be able to decide this one already from the mechanics of material. Believe it or not, you may ask people dumb about it. Okay, the knowledge of the second year is supposed to be, and there is another one. The community frame over here. This one is in front of the academic building one. Okay, but this one have 2 wings. Okay, the first one have only 1 wing. This is more symmetric structure, and there is large stadium. Okay, that may have a large roof. Or surface structure, and it can be steel surface structure, and it can be like a polymeric material. It's called a composite material. And this one, Colorado International Airport, actually is really huge. When it's finished, it's the second largest airport in the US in Colorado. And they put the composite material at the roof because they simulate the camp of the late Indian, okay, the Native American Indian. And then let me go a bit more. That is the road, okay? So we can finish this one. When we talking about the road, you got to follow two things. For most of the structural design, you got to follow the building code, because this one, building code is the legal code specified by the government agency, and it said about the minimum design load. I said before, okay, it depends on you. If this is a kindergarten, you may do 150 kilogram per square meter, but for somehow you're thinking about Harlem meeting room also, you may move it to the 300 kilogram per square meter. Your structure will be larger, but it can take more load. And then this is in various countries. This one is in Thailand, in Bangkok area, for only building code that cover our country. There is a building code that's like 14 years old already, nearly. And this one for the US, it's written on the region for the ensign. Most of the state in the east use the ensign, and you will see most of the state on the western side use it, and it's legal. But there is another one. Since the building code is really old, such as in Thailand, we have like a 40 years old building code. We have another code called design code. This is the technical detail. Okay, for the analysis and design is developed by professional organization in Thailand. It is the Engineering Institute of Thailand. And then there is various code about it. Okay, it can be steel, it can be reinforced concrete, it can be displaced concrete. And in different countries, you also have different design code. I don't know if you go back to Cambodia, you have it or not, or Cambodian just adopt the code from French or the code from any country. It depends on the country. Okay. SDM. Okay. Oh, there's still French code. I still wonder, French governed Cambodia for like 60 years, but the influence of French still there? Oh, I see. They graduate from French, so they're going to teach follow the French system. Because of what I'm asking, because that is Korean company. Okay, come to Cambodia, Chinese company. And then for the Chinese company, we know they use most of the time, they use their own code to your code. Okay, but that seems to be very flexible for your government. Okay, it's depend on the standard because the government have the authority to analyze, to allow any acceptable international code to do so. For America, this one for the American Concrete Institute, or if you like to design the bridge, okay, you got to follow the ASTO. And for the steel, it's the SC. And I think Ajahn Mungkhon, Ajahn Nok, when they teach the RC, they also use one as the basic. And for teaching the steel, they use this one. So anyway, you may download it. There are a lot of them. And then the dead load is the permanent load that I said before. The load is dead, it's still there, it won't move. Okay, most of the time it's self-weight. So the detail of the dead load can be based on the density of the material. Okay, and it's also depend on the type of the structural member, such as roof material, timber roof, those kind of things, simply to group. You should be careful about it. Okay, for the material, see the unit is in per cubic, it's different density, but for the type of the material in function is going to be in the square meter. And when you thinking about this one, for the structure, if you like to calculate the cell weight, okay, of the RC beam, most of the time since the beam is continuous, so the cell weight is going to be uniformly distributed load, the model Hopkin. And you just compute only 1 meter, the volume is in cubic meter, right? So you got to find the cross-sectional area. I like you guys to look it by yourself. I won't go in detail of this one. If for this one, you just combine this portion is what? This portion is the flank, okay, the width of 55 millimeter times the thickness. So this one is area of the flank. And this one is the area of the web, only this portion. And then you have the area with what? With only 1 meter length, you get the volume of the concrete. Okay. And then since this one consider only the concrete, you just open for the density of the concrete, just pump it for 1 meter of the beam. Okay, this one is 2.714 kilonewton. So distributed load is 2.714 kilonewton per meter. But if I then consider the steel reinforcement also, okay, you got to consider it. Okay, you can do so, right? I got to provide you with the volume. You got to consider the volume of the steel and the density of the steel. Anyway, you may use the larger value from this one, okay, most of the time, but in the capstone design, they won't allow you. But in reality, they won't use 2.71 most of the time, they just put it a bit larger. And then you got to be able to calculate this reaction, shear diagram, bending moment diagram. And later, you're supposed to be able to determine the elastic curve, okay, at the before the end of midterm number 3. And then there is another example of this one, compute the dead load. But this one is in combination, not only the beam, okay, before that, only the beam, only the concrete. Not only the beam, only the concrete, but at the reinforcement. And you may say we got 2.714 without considering the steel. Okay, sometimes they just take it to 3. That means they also include the steel already. But for this one, there is 3 types of material. One is the RC. Okay, RC slab over here. RC slab is over here. And then concrete measuring unit, that's in the yellow. Okay. And then there is the plaster ceiling, this is the black. Yellow, green, and black. And they set up on this from the RC. They provide you with the density per cubic meter for the concrete measuring unit. Again, in cubic meter. But for the plaster ceiling, it's in square meter. So in the calculation of this one, you just consider all the things for only 1 meter, okay? And then the weight of the wall, the weight of the floor, the weight of ceiling will transfer to the beam, okay? The problem over here, still deficient. They didn't include the beam, the weight of the beam, okay? So intention, just put this example, combined with the previous one, okay? You will get this one. So for the concrete slab, you got to compute, okay, the cross section, copy it, 2 meter. This width is 2 meter, and this is 0.1 meter, 10 centimeter in the thickness. This is going to be cross sectional area, time what? Time 1 meter, and time density. And then for the plaster ceiling, you just time the area. This is 1 meter. This is 2 meter. This is only the area. You don't need to time the thickness. Okay. And then you got 0.4. And the last one, brick. This is going to be the wall. So you may compute. This is 2.5 meter and 30 centimeter. This is going to be the cross section, okay, and then time 1 meter, okay, and then you just combine it. This is only the weight of the wall, floor, and ceiling without the weight of the beam. And when I put it in the examination, I will include the beam into it also, and I will ask you to draw the model of this one, okay. Sometimes I also ask you to determine the reaction. You're supposed to be able to, right? Because it's the old knowledge from instead. And then the last example, this I-beam, most of the time is the precast, pre-stressed concrete beam. And now they include the reinforcement into this problem, okay? And they provide you a lot of data, and you got to find which one you're going to use. Okay, leave the problem carefully. The girder, the pre-stressed concrete girder, made with what? Made with plain stone concrete, and this is going to be concrete plain stone over here. And you can see there is a lot of concrete. See. You got to select a proper one. And there is 4 cone format. Okay, that is going to be what? Going to be the steel. Okay, cone door. Okay, and that is going to be the data you're going to use. That is for steel. Now, you determine the date, right? Okay, and then what is going to be the volume of the concrete per meter. So we only consider this one for the length of 1 meter. That's going to be kilonewton per meter. You got to compute. Compute for what? Compute for the area of the concrete. You got to look it carefully. Actually, I have this calculation in last year lecture, okay, just compute. You don't need to compute the area of the lot, okay? You find the concrete subset from the lot. the log only 1 meter also. And then can you determine the area of the log, right? This is going to be what? The area. Pi. This is what? Diameter, right? Pi d square over 4. And then there is 4 of them, right? Times 4. Okay, you got to use this one. This is going to be a of the log. You determine the area of the concrete. You got to subtract the area of the log out. Okay, and then you times it by this one. Okay, and then you going to be what? Going to be area of this concrete minus area of the log. Okay, actually area not concrete, area of the beam minus area of the log is going to be area of the beam only for the concrete. Okay, and then you times this one by this one. Now for the area of the log, this one will times 22.6. okay, but for this one it's going to times what? 77.3. okay, and then you combine them per meter. Do it by yourself. If not, go to the last year lecture. And also for this one, you go to the last year lecture. I already have it. Okay. And that is going to be the lecture for today. And hope you have some homework, at least to, you don't need to turn it into PBNDAM. Okay. Homework for yourself. Okay. Practice for your examination. And then that's all for today. Any questions?